Okay, good morning, Sequoia Middle School. Happy Monday, October 24th. It's the first day of the 10th week of school, so time's really starting to fly here for us. Just wanted to talk to you this morning about a few things. Is the ACS test. Now, the ACS tests are going to be taken this week. ACS stands for Assessment of Critical Standards. And they are benchmark tests or kind of preparation tests for the CSTs. And the CST tests are the ones that we take, or STAR tests, are the ones that we take in April or May. These tests that we're taking right now, the ACS tests, are preparation, they're kind of warm-ups for those big tests. They're important though because they help us show or prove what you've learned in the first quarter. So I need you to take these tests very serious. I need you to put forth your maximum effort. I need you to do your best to show what you've learned. So let's practice some real simple things. Like, make sure you get plenty of rest this week, make sure you eat a good breakfast every morning, and make sure you come to school prepared to concentrate and do your best. So ACS tests this week, you'll take those in English, math, history, and some of you will be taking benchmark tests in science as well. So make sure you're putting forth your best effort to prove to yourself, to your teachers, to your parents, that you have learned a lot this first quarter. Believe it or not, high school will look at these tests to see, even these ACS tests, to see how you're doing when they try to decide what classes to put you in. So put forth your best effort and prove once again to yourself, your teachers, and your parents that you've learned a lot this first quarter. Okay, so many of you have done very well here our first quarter, and we're excited to celebrate this Friday coming up, our first SAC pack. Now, Miss Domingo has been working very hard on getting some really fun things together for SAC pack for those of you that qualify. And remember, to qualify, you have to have at least a 2.0. You can't have any Fs, less than 4 tardies, good attendance, and no days in transition or suspension. So those of you, and there's many of you, most of you in fact, will be able to participate this week. And we're excited about having you come out and have fun in the afternoon on Friday. Have some great games and activities, a movie, and then at 2:30 today, or excuse me, not today, on Friday, we will have our first dance. For all students that are invited to participate in SAC pack, we'll also be able to go to our first dance. It'll be free for you. It'll be from 2:30 to 4:30 in the cafeteria. We've hired a DJ. He's going to do a great job. It'll be a lot of fun. It is a Halloween theme. Just let me real quickly say this. No costumes to the Halloween dance, and no costumes on the 31st, which is Halloween, which is a week from today. Please, no costumes to school. We'll have to send you home if you come to school in a costume. So let me talk just real quickly. SAC pack, going to be a lot of fun. We're excited about those of you who have done well here first quarter. We want to encourage you to continue to do well, because it's important not only so you can participate in these fun activities, but of course it's most important that your grades and your effort in here at Sequoia will prepare you for high school and prepare you for the rest of your life. The habits you form right now while you are in school will continue with you for the rest of your life. So if you're a good student, you become a good employee, and a good employee has a good job and can take care of your family and have the things that you want in life. So all these things are formed as part of habits, little things like doing your homework, getting your classwork done, staying on task, following directions from your teachers, all very important ideas as you get ready for high school and for the rest of your life. Now, some of you are not going to be able to participate in SAC pack because your grades, because you had an F, or more than one F, or you have below a 2.0. Let me talk about that for just a second. We are in our second cycle of mandatorial, so some of you are having to participate. About 90 of you are having to participate in mandatorial last week and this week. Now, we're going to pull your grades next week. And if your grades are good, you will not have to continue in mandatorial. If you, those of you who let your grades slip and you have 2 or more Fs, you will have to start mandatorial in a couple weeks. So keep that in mind. Make sure that you're keeping your grades up so you do not have to lose your lunchtime privileges to mandatorial. But also, we want to make sure that you get those grades up, because once again, it helps you prepare for high school and for the rest of your life. Now, a couple other important things I want to mention this morning. We want to congratulate our fall sports teams. As you've heard, our volleyball team was city champs for the first time. That's awesome. Congratulations, girls, on an undefeated season. Coach Badashi, they all did a great job. We also want to recognize our other teams that also did a great job, and those were our golf team, which finished third in the whole city. That's out of 14 middle schools, highest they've ever finished. Congratulations, golf team. Our cross country team finished fourth. That's out of 14 teams. Again, very, very awesome to do so well with our cross country team. And then our football team had a great season. Not as many wins maybe as we hoped, but we're ready for next year. We know we had some great players out there and some great games. We came close and did win some games as well. So congratulations to the football team and to our coaches. Also want you to know that it's time for winter sports now. So basketball for boys, soccer for girls and boys, and wrestling for girls and boys has begun. If you have not gone out for a sport yet, you need to go out and participate in sports or something else. But let's talk about sports real quick. Get out there today, go to the cafeteria at 2:30, get signed up, get out there and try out for sports. It's a great way to be involved in school and a great way for you to, another great way, believe it or not, to prepare for high school for the rest of your life. Because sports or other activities like cheerleading, dance, after school program, they do prepare you. We want to congratulate those teams again. Okay, so the last thing I want to talk to you about today is Red Ribbon Week. Red Ribbon Week, of course, we celebrate or talk a lot about not doing drugs and staying away from drugs. We've got some cool activities. Mrs. Felder has spent a lot of time getting ready for this week, so it should be a great week here on campus. Remember what we're doing all this to remember that we do not and should stay away from drugs. Let's talk to you just for a minute about that, and then we'll talk about our activities this week. Probably all of you know someone who has ruined their life with drugs. I do. I bet you most of your teachers do. And probably most of you know either a relative, a friend, a neighbor who has ruined their life using drugs. Guys, it's important that you know, that you understand that these people all started by making small, simple mistakes like using pot once or marijuana, simple things like that, that then become even bigger things and eventually really do ruin their life. So the best way to avoid terrible decisions like this is to just never use drugs. Just say no. You've heard that before. I want to share a video with you real quick. This is a video actually that we used to watch on TV when I was a lot younger. So watch this video. It talks about drugs. It's real quick. It's just a couple of advertisements about why we should stay away from drugs. And then I'll talk to you a little bit about activities this week for Red Ribbon Week.
Is there anyone out there who still isn't clear about what doing drugs does? Okay, last time. This is your brain. This is drugs. This is your brain on drugs. Any questions?
You don't want to smoke weed. Turning down friends can be tricky.
Hey, Mike. Want some?
No way, man. That stuff's illegal.
Hey, Mike. Want some?
I'm allergic.
Hey, Mike. Want some?
No. I gotta stay level.
Mike. Want some?
Time out.
It's just not for me.
It's cool.
Be confident. Be honest. Just be yourself.
Okay, so hopefully you got the message there, and the message is that drugs are not good for you. They can ruin your life, ruin your brain, just like that egg showed you. But it's important that you make good choices around drugs and stay away from drugs. Which leads me to an important point before, one last thing I want to talk about before we talk about activities. And that is, if you know of something bad that's happening on this campus, or on any campus, it is important that you let us know. It's you tell someone, tell an adult, tell a teacher, tell me, tell Ms. Ballesteros, Ms. Domingo, Mr. Bordona, any adult, Carl Ray, it doesn't matter. Tell an adult what's going on so we can stop things from happening that are going to hurt people or stop things from happening that could make it bad for other people on this campus. We do use Crime Stoppers here, so if you share something that leads to an arrest, we will make sure that we will pursue money for you. For helping out and doing the right thing. So please make sure you're making good choices here on this campus. And if you know of people that are not making good choices, please share that with an adult. All right, so here's the last thing we're going to do today. I just want to talk to you a little bit about activities for this week so we're prepared for Red Ribbon Week. The first thing is, today is, let me grab something here, Shade Out Drugs Day. So I don't know about you, but I got my glasses here. I hope you brought your sunglasses today. These are my big shades to shade out the drugs. Make sure that you look for me on campus today to be wearing these. If you don't like these, check out these shades. These are pretty awesome too. Peace. Hope you like those as well. So Monday is Shade Out Drugs Day. Tuesday is Put a Cap on Drugs. So I believe we're supposed to wear an ugly hat. So here we go. I got my ugliest hat I could find. That's right. It is. Yeah, see that? Oh, that's ugly. Man, that's right. It's a Computech hat. So I'm not going to keep that on any longer. Get rid of that ugly hat. Actually, I think it's crazy hat. So I got one that's kind of Halloween themed. There we go. You like my crazy hat? Make sure you wear a crazy hat on Tuesday. Wednesday will be Cupcake Walk and Face Painting Day. So that should be fun at lunchtime. Then on Thursday is Crazy Tie Day. So put a tie on drugs. All right, I got a few ugly ties, but look at this one. Nice, huh? How about that Christmas tie? Kind of ugly, kind of crazy. So make sure on Thursday you wear an ugly tie. I'm sure somebody out there has got an ugly tie you can borrow. And then on Friday, the day that I'm looking forward to, and that is Put Drugs to Sleep by wearing your pajamas to school. So here's my my favorite Paul Frank pajamas. I'll be wearing those on Friday. So make sure you wear, you can wear, this is the only day, by the way, students, you can wear pajamas to school. So you can wear those, and we'll have SAC pack again on Friday for those that are participating. But everywhere, everybody can wear their pajamas that day. So one last thing as we go out here, I've got a little short video to share with you. Remember our Red Ribbon Rally from Friday? It was an awesome, awesome rally, great participation. Saw some really cool things. So we'll go out showing you a couple things from that rally and look forward to seeing you out there on campus. Red Ribbon Week, just say no to drugs.